Okay, so let's just get right into it. I just finished watching the latest Texas Chainsaw Massacre flick brought to us by Netflix. This is brought to us by David Blue Garcia, whose only other directing credit is a movie called Tejano from 2018, which I have not seen, and written by Fede Alvarez, who also wrote Don't Breathe and Evil Dead from 2013. Which some call a remake. I call it more of a secret sequel. I went into this movie with a pretty open mind. I watched the trailer. I had some thoughts about it, but there's the thing about trailers is, especially nowadays, is oftentimes you don't know what's actually being marketed. And that's actually happened a lot through the years, is a ton of films will either get shitty marketing or not enough marketing, and you'll have a lot of fly-by-night, under-the-radar films that end up becoming cult favorites later down the line because of crappy marketing. I mean, look what happened to Nicholas Refn's Drive. That was marketed as like a Fast and the Furious film, and evidently that's not something someone wanted to see at the time, but anybody that watched the movie anyway seemed to quite enjoy it and found it a very Michael Mann-style throwback sort of film. So don't always trust the marketing of a film. If a trailer looks shitty, chances are it might just be a shitty trailer. In regards to Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2022, the trailer did make it look pretty goddamn bad, especially with some of the famous things that people are talking about, like that one shot of Leatherface. You know which one I'm talking about, and I'll make the obvious joke that everybody else is making. And of course, the whole Leatherface on the bus, and then everybody points their phones at him, and there's the one guy that goes, "Have fun being canceled, bro," or whatever the fuck. Now, people have had their thoughts on the trailer, and we've had a lot of naysayers, and there's been a lot of people that have been excited about it. Now, with the movie being out for a couple of days now, it's been very hot and cold, and nothing really in the middle. There seems to be people that either really like it or think it's the biggest pile of shit in the world. And I'm going to tell you my thoughts about it, because over the years, I've had my thoughts regarding the Texas Chainsaw Massacre as a franchise as a whole. And if you want to know more extensive thoughts that I've had about these films, please do check out some of the other videos I've done on Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3, which is my personal favorite of the franchise, Texas Chainsaw Massacre The Next Generation, which I'm not going to tell you whether it's still my least favorite of the franchise. For the sake of keeping this closer to just the topic of the latest 2022 film, I've decided to cut out all of my ramblings on the entire Texas Chainsaw Massacre franchise. You can find information on that in other videos that I've made on the franchise, but for here, let's try to talk about just the new movie. All right, let's skip forward here and see if I'm done rambling. But that wasn't enough. We also needed another prequel, and this time,
God damn it,
of a prequel to the original film, Leatherface, which came out in, what was that one, 2017. This one was kind of a fart. It went by, and that was it. I don't really have an opinion on it. I don't even know if I've seen the whole thing. It just didn't really interest me. I don't really care about Leatherface as a little boy. I don't need to see little Bubba. I want big Bubba. I'm just reminded of Caligula. Do you like little boys? Do you like little Bubbas? No, sire. Big Bubbas. Now, one thing I promised myself I wouldn't do is that I wouldn't prattle on about the franchise as a whole. I've done that a number of times on not only YouTube, but on my Twitch as well. So if you want to go check out some of that stuff, I will add those in the description below. I want to mainly focus on talking about Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2022, how it holds up with the rest of the franchise. Do I like it overall as a film? Did I hate it? Do I love it? Whose side do I stand on as far as the horror fandom goes, or whatever the fuck you want to call it? Because again, there's always got to be a fucking discourse every time a new, like, horror franchise slasher revitalization comes around. Are you with it? Are you against it? If you hate it, you're wrong. If you like it, you're wrong. Well, I'm just going to give you my opinion. And if you don't like my opinion, fuck you. I don't care. My initial thoughts to this film is that I felt like it wasn't really necessary on paper. Like, hearing about another, and this is what this film is, it's another Texas Chainsaw Massacre, The Real Part 2. And it's like, if you want to talk about how confusing the Halloween franchise is, take a fucking seat, because at least most of the whole Michael Myers lore He had a whole series before they finally started trying to do the pick-your-own-adventure shit. Leatherface has had this going for him since after the second Tobe Hooper film. So, give it a fucking rest. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre franchise might be the most chronologically confusing ever, because there is no part three, and everything else is a remake or a prequel. Like, fucking wow. So how does this one hold up as far as the realm of being the real part two? Because it has a couple films to stand up against, like Leatherface, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3, like Texas Chainsaw from 2013. And I've got to say, I prefer this one over the 2013 film, but I still prefer Leatherface, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3 as my favorite. But I will say this. This one is way the fuck better than Next Generation, I can tell you that much. So, this one is not my least favorite in the series. My least favorite is still The Next Generation. Fuck that film to smithereens. Let's go with some of the plot elements of this one before I really get into it. Just a summary rundown of, I think summary and rundown mean exactly the same thing. These influencers, like Instagram types, have supposedly bought up property in this old ghost town in Texas that's its infrastructure is dead. They're going to try to revitalize it. They're going to turn into a fucking millennial zoomer utopia or whatever. And they're driving out the old community. They've apparently got a deed to the town. So they're basically going in to start setting up shop. But it also happens to be very nearby where the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre took place. And there's some interesting elements in there. Talking about the events of the first film, I actually quite like the opening of this one, where we have a classic original Texas Chainsaw Massacre style narration at the beginning, kind of explaining what happened back in 1974. And I do think it's actually interesting to note that the narration in this movie is from the original John Larroquette. Yes, the original narrator of the first film's opening text crawl, Mr. Nightcourt himself. The characters in this film are mostly really smug and really annoying, though I think that's intentional. I don't think this movie is trying to be and I hate using the term, a woke film. I think it's actually trying to make fun of some of those types, like the ultra trying too hard to be ultra virtuous types. You kind of get that vibe with the dude that's buying the town and his girlfriend, but not everybody is entirely annoying in this film. I actually quite liked the younger sister character, Lila, played by Elsie Fisher. I actually felt like she was kind of the glue that held a lot of those characters together. She was a little more level-headed. She, I think, saw the world in more of a real way, as opposed to these other folks that have this idea that they can just set up shop wherever they want, and they're going to have a utopia for people of their age to basically live a life that's drama and violence and is free from having to deal with the political stances that they're not for, and they can live in their own little bubble. And that's what I kind of mean, that a lot of these characters are, in my opinion, meant to be pretty annoying, like very self-entitled, very self-important. They think they can just come into this old town, push the old people out of it, and set up shop. And what really drives that point forward is they find an old orphanage. There's an old lady there that is obviously been having trouble breathing for a long fucking time. She's old as shit. Just this decrepit old lady. And this is where we start to get the hints of where we're going to see Leatherface, because we see a photo in the orphanage. Shows a very rather large man built like our boy Gunnar Hansen that's there surrounded by the little children. And I'll just get into my own little personal theories as to how Leatherface ended up here, because yes, that is meant to be Leatherface. It ends up being Leatherface. I think after, because none of the other movies were meant to happen. Like, there, in this universe, there is no part two, there is no Leatherface, there is no Next Generation, even though none of those are actually part twos anyway. But the Bill Moseley shit and the Caroline Williams stuff, the Dennis Hopper, I'm the Lord of the Harvest, bring it down! Like, none of that shit happened. That's none of that. We nixed that out of the fucking plot entirely. It's leading you to believe that Leatherface maybe walked away, started drifting, was basically just a wandering off and it was probably found by this old lady, and she took him into the orphanage, raised him as her own. We're sort of led to believe anyway in the first film that he's kind of got the mind of a child, so I guess he was never caught and somehow integrated into society in this way of being looked after by this old lady. Like, okay, fine. It's not great, but let's go with it. This is their way of explaining where Leatherface has been all this time, and yeah, it's not great, it's not terrible. They had a lot to work with. They literally had 50 years in between to explain what the fuck Leatherface has been doing all this time. Don't tell us anything about what happened to Drayton Sawyer. Don't tell us anything about what happened to the old farmhouse. I guess that doesn't matter, even though Drayton was a pretty fucking integral character, but hey, whatever. The old lady has, by the way, nothing to do with the Sawyer bloodline. She has a completely different name, which is why I'm led to believe that she just took him in as a young man, because Leatherface is meant to be a young man in the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Gunnar Hansen, who played him originally, was actually about 26, 27. So let's just say in the first film, Leatherface was 27 years old. So all this fucking time goes by. These millennials show up into town. They want to buy everything up. They want to gentrify everything. Everybody's getting moved out of the town. The old lady has a heart attack as she's being taken out to, I guess, a shelter or something. One of the teens or 20-somethings goes along in the paddy wagon for some fucking reason. The only thing I can think of is that to be used as a plot device so she can tell about the horrors that happen on the road, because the old lady has a heart attack. The guy who's obviously Leatherface loses his fucking mind. He murders the cops that are in there. He takes the old lady's face and wears it, which I only imagine is some sort of tactic of vengeance or some shit. He kills the young chick that was in the paddy wagon and makes his way back to the town to go all Texas Chainsaw Massacre on motherfuckers. And I'll start with the good here, and I am going to talk about elements that I enjoyed, and actually there was more in this film that I enjoyed than I thought I would. I will say, the gore, top-notch. Leatherface looks pretty fucking cool, and the guy that got to play him actually resembles Gunnar Hansen quite a bit in physicality. I didn't mind that. This film actually features a Texas Chainsaw Massacre. If you go back and look at pretty much every film in the franchise, and I'm talking sequels, prequels, remakes, there's no actual Texas Chainsaw Massacre. There's a few kills with a chainsaw, but there's no, like, room full of people getting fucking splattered to shit with a chainsaw. This movie has that, and it is, unfortunately, during the cringy moment of, "You're canceled, bro." But you know what? I think we're meant to want to watch those fuckers die. Self-entitled fucking idiots that, at the moment of trouble, they pull out their goddamn phones. I'm glad Leatherface mowed these fuckers down. That scene, 10 out of 10, motherfucker. That was great. Some of the other good elements here, the soundtrack I really enjoyed, because there really was no soundtrack in this film. It was actually a lot of ambient noise, which, if you remember from the 74 film, that's mainly what it is. In the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre, you hear a lot of weird, like, droning in the background, mechanical noises, the buzzing of a saw, the buzzing of an engine, which I always thought really added a creepy tone to the original film, and this flick kind of does that. I feel like that was their intent with the background noise of the film. Instead of having a soundtrack, you have ambience, you have mood, and I enjoyed that quite a bit. And I gotta say, I'm looking forward to seeing what else David Garcia puts out in the future, because this was a nice-looking movie. It captured the heat of Texas really well. It had some great fucking color. It had some great mood. There were some really atmospheric shots. I have to say, as far as, like, visually goes, great looking film. And then, of course, sound wise, I enjoyed the ambient kind of lack of soundtrack, because that really was the spirit of the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre. There was barely any music in that film, and I thought that was a cool touch. And then, of course, let's get to some of the bad here. And I've already talked about some of the characters that I thought were smug and annoying and kind of self-entitled. But again, I feel like that was the intent. I feel like we weren't supposed to like every character in this film, but they did give us a few people to root for. But I'm not just going to go about the characters here, because I've already talked about that. That was already kind of at the beginning of the video. I want to talk about some of the actual story elements that I thought were just dumb. A main one being how Leatherface gets his chainsaw back. This was fucking stupid. I mean, I knew he was obviously going to get his chainsaw at some point. That was a given. I thought he was going to get it from some, like, fucking old gas station or something after, you know, the paddy wagon scene. But no, he has his original chainsaw from the fucking first movie hidden in a wall of the orphanage he was staying in, which, so did the old lady know he was Leatherface? Did he somehow sneak it in there? Because it's hid behind some fucking thick wall. He has to fucking sledgehammer like Triple H his way through that shit, which was dumb, and it still had the gasoline in it, and it's like, you have to figure, this thing's probably been in there since like between 1974 and 1976. We don't know when he was, actually no, it was 74, because the photo at the orphanage specifically states 1974. You see a photo of the big lug behind all the kids, like Leatherface and Leatherface is friends to the children, you know, like he's been there for a while. He's been there for 50 fucking years, for 51 years. So that chainsaw has been in there with the old guzzling that was in there, and it still functions. Like it takes him no effort to get the fucking thing started up. I would have really preferred it if he just found it on his way back to the town after the paddy wagon crashes and he killed the motherfuckers and gets his face. Like, you don't need to go that far with the fucking nostalgia to get the original chainsaw back. Leatherface didn't need his original chainsaw. I doubt that chainsaw meant that much to him. I'm pretty sure he could pick up any saw and fucking use it. Doesn't matter the color or the type. As long as it saws people the fuck up and it hacks up human meat for barbecue, he's gonna be happy with that shit. Gripe the second. I thought Sally Hardesty being included in this was fucking stupid. She was completely inconsequential. None of her scenes really matter. She actually has Leatherface, like, in her fucking crosshairs, about to gun him down as he's sitting down on a bed, and she's trying to give him the morality talk, like, you killed my friends, look at this photo, you killed my friends, and he ignores her and just walks out of the fucking room. Solid 5 minutes goes by, Leatherface starts terrorizing the two sisters in a truck, Sally shows up again, fucking aims at him, shoots him a bunch of times. Like, Leatherface, for one, here's another dumb thing, is basically the Terminator in this film. He takes fucking bullet after bullet after bullet, and this motherfucker doesn't go down. I was actually expecting at one point where he gets shot a bunch of times in, like, the chest for it to, like, zoom in on him and have him do the fucking Robert Patrick. Like, I swear to fucking God, it's that ridiculous. But Sally being in this was pointless. Marilyn Burns has been dead for like 6 years. Rest in peace. I thought bringing back another actress to play her, especially, spoiler alert, to very quickly kill her off. Whatever. The overall ending was just dumb as fuck too. It becomes a cartoon. Like, you know, I was talking about how Leatherface takes bullet after bullet after bullet. You have to take into account the guy's like, the character's gotta be like 80. He's pushing 80 years old, late 70s at this point. He still moves like a young man, for one. He can still fucking Gunnar Hansen run with that fucking saw and catch up to people. Which I think was a neat little callback to the first movie, because in actuality, when they were filming the chase scenes in the woods in the first Texas Chainsaw Massacre, Gunnar Hansen would actually constantly catch up to Marilyn Burns. And this was Gunnar in fucking cowboy boots with lifts, mind you, running with a chainsaw and catching up to her. So I guess they were going for that, like, this was the physicality of the original character, but it doesn't make a whole lot of sense when he's fucking 80. An 80-year-old cannibal, okay? He's not exactly the pinnacle of health, unless you want to go for some thing where he's like, oh, Leatherface has been a metahuman this whole time, which, if you want to tell me that, fuck you. But just, it turns into complete camp by the end of the film. Like, you got Leatherface, like, impaling people and lifting them into the air and throwing them fucking 80 feet away, getting shot like a bazillion times, stalking the characters in an old movie theater, which, albeit as stupid as it was, had some of the coolest lighting in the film, I will give it that, but it was so dumb. I'll just look at some of this shit, and I think the only music I think that would be appropriate to what I saw going on there is this. So I'm not going to say what happens at the very end of the movie. I will say it was hysterical and I laughed my ass off. I will say overall, didn't hate this movie. It had its flaws, it had its ups, it had its downs. I honestly found myself enjoying it for the most part. I found it to be worth watching. I thought it had some really nice direction and I thought it had some nice visuals. I loved Leatherface in the film, even though you're not supposed to root for the killer. But then again, I'm a slasher fan. I always root for Jason. I always root for Myers. I always root for Freddy. I always root for Leatherface. And this was a very rootable Leatherface. And I know my opinion is a lot less harsh than some of my colleagues, but I can't help it. I'm honest when it comes to this shit. I ended up liking this. I thought this was a lot better than the new Scream. I thought it was better than Halloween Kills. I enjoyed Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2022. It was a worthy addition to the series. Do I feel like there needs to be more? I don't know. I feel like maybe stop with Leatherface for a while. But this was fine. This was one of the better ones to come out in a long time. It was better than Leatherface from 2017. I thought it was better than Texas Chainsaw Massacre from 2013, which I didn't even hate. It was way the fuck better than Texas Chainsaw Massacre, The Next Generation. If I were to rank it, for me, the ranking goes as follows, and you're probably not going to agree with me, but for me, it goes from best to, let's just say, lesser best. Let's just say this is my list of favorites. The third film, Leatherface, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3. The very first film, Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2. The Platinum Dunes remake and prequel. And right there at the end, Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2022. It's not the best. It's not the worst. It's certainly not the fucking worst. I put it up there with the ones that I revisit, and I could see myself revisiting this one, if anything, for some of the really awesome carnage that's in this film. Like, this is a fucking gorehound's dream. There's some great practical gore effects in this one. We get an actual Texas Chainsaw Massacre, and we get a very serviceable Leatherface. I like Leatherface in this film. He was played by Mark Burnham, who is a big fucking dude. Very, very similar to the physicality of our boy, Gunnar Hansen. Rest in peace. I don't think I've seen this dude in anything else, but I imagine if he's in anything, it's usually to play a huge fucking guy. So yeah, Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2022. I kind of dug it. You know, like, I have my gripes with it. Obviously, this is a review. I have to state what I like. I have to state what I don't like. But I ended up liking it a lot more than I thought I would. I would recommend it. If you're on the fence about it, maybe go check it out. Because when I saw the trailer, my reaction was not exactly the best one. I thought it kind of looked like shit. And I feel like the movie we actually got was a lot better than what the trailer actually gave us. So, yeah, that's it. That's pretty much all I got to say. I am about to go do a fucking live stream on Twitch. This video is probably going to be up by Monday or Tuesday. I'm about to go do some Fred Olin Ray flicks. Thanks for watching, everybody. Do you agree with me? Do you disagree? What are your thoughts on Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2022? What's your personal favorite in the series? What's your least favorite in the series? I'll catch you next time.
Leatherfuck.
Oh, God damn it.